Let us start with factors. Factors are the numbers which exactly divides another number. For example, factors of 10 are 1, 2, 5 and 10. That means they can completely divide the number 10 without leaving any remainder. Let us move on to the next topic, how to find factors. Let us take one example, 20. So there are many methods. I'll be using one of them. So if you know any other method, you can use that too also. So I will be thinking about what should I multiply in 1 to get 20. So I'll be multiplying it by 20. So what should I multiply by 2 to get 20? Yeah, that easy. That is 10. What should I multiply by 3? So it will come in decimal. That is not required. We should multiply by a whole number. So moving on to the next. What should I multiply by 4 to get 20? Yes, it is 5. What should I multiply by 5? Oh, 5 we have already taken, so we can stop over here and that's it. So it is repetition. So till when we have to do? Till the time it is getting repeated. Now if I look this way, so factors of 20 are, if you can see, 1, 2, 4, 5, 10 and 20. So you can find the factors of any given number like this. Let us quickly see the factors of one more example, that is 28. So as you can see, these are the only number which can divide, which can divide 28. So we can again write, so factors of 28 are 1, 2, 4, 7, 14 and 28. So this is how we can find factors. So coming to our next topic, which is finding common factors. So common factors of 20 and 28, we can find it two ways. One is finding the common one. Obviously that's easy. First of all, find the factors like this way and find the common one. So as you can see, 1 is common, 2 is common, 4 is common. Is there anything else which is common? So I can write common factors of 20 and 28 are 1, 2 and 4. So there is one more way of finding out the common factor. This is called Venn diagram, which you will be studying soon. Okay. So what I can do is I can write factors of 28 over here. Oh, sorry, 20 over here and factors of 28 in this circle. And whatever the factors which are common, I can write it over here. So what I can do is write the common factors in the middle. That is 1, 2 and 4. So these are the common factors in both of them. And rest of the factors I can write 5, 10 and 20 here. And 7, 14 and 28 in this part. So this common part is known as common factors. So let us try to understand why we are so bothered about common factors. So common factors are those numbers which can divide both 20 and 28. Okay, let us see. 20 is divisible by 1? Yes. 20 is divisible by 2? Yes, in the table of 2. And 28 is divisible by 2 also, 14. And 20 is divisible by 4. And 28 is also divisible by 4. So in this way, common factors will let you know whether two numbers or three numbers also have a common divisible, by which number it will be commonly divisible. Let me just help you out. If you find the highest number, highest common factor is 4. As you can see, 1, 2 and 4. Out of these, what is the highest common factor? It is 4. What does it mean? It is nothing but HCF. So, highest common factor is that number, highest number among all the factors of 20 and 28, which can divide both 20 and 28. Where does it help? Let me just give you one example. Suppose you are having 20 upon 28 question and you need to reduce it. If you have the understanding of HCF, you will be able to know that these two numbers are divisible by 4. That is the common factor. It divides. Factor means divides. So I will be dividing this and this by 4. Dividing it by 4, I will be getting here, what I will be getting? 5. And here I will be getting 7. So 5 upon 7 is the simplest form of 20 and 28. This is one application. There are many more. So in the next video, we will be looking at the common multiples. So think about that thing, and until then, keep learning.